And then as we started playing, you know, I thought to myself, well, now just a minute. I think I was playing Brazilian music before you were even born. But of course, you developed the expertise, having lived there and studied with the natural teachers, where I really was coming from the perspective of a jazz musician playing a few bossa novas and sambas by Luis Bonfa and Antonio Carlos Jobim. But your experience is much deeper than that in Brazilian music.
Yeah, and one of the interesting things we've done is to play different types of Brazilian music, not just bossa nova and samba like you mentioned, right? But I introduced frevo, right, and baião, and some types of choros and maxixe, and so it's been very fun to explore those other styles and also how jazz influenced those styles, right? So we can say we play Brazilian jazz, but inside of that Brazilian jazz, we have a lot of subgenres.
Well, that's right. And as I describe the music, for instance, the choro, to people, I will say, you know, it's like folkloric music in classical forms with jazz influences and improvising as well. So it's got all those aspects, the folkloric, the classical, and jazz.
It's interesting how it develops and the jazz becomes so present in the choro. The same thing that happened with samba, right? It have that rustic, primitive samba, and then suddenly cool jazz comes in, and Tom Jobim and right, Chico Buarque, all those composers, of course, João Gilberto, right? Mm-hmm. One of the first ones to introduce those chords and that different a way of playing samba, right? It's much softer. So, and that's why we also do in our duo, we also explore some those classics of bossa nova. We play mm-hmm. wave and corcovado and right. And well, many other desafinado we also play, yeah. Right? Yeah. And we give a little twist on that and our own flavors.
And the film Black Orpheus, which was so important from the late 1950s, won the Cannes Film Festival Award, won the Oscar for Best Foreign Film, Black Orpheus, Orfeo Negra. And it's the the phenomenon that brought Brazilian music to the world. And there was then a bossa nova craze.
Yeah, that's true.
In the United States and Canada.
And I think that's one of the things I really like in our concerts is that we have this, we introduce this educational component, right? As we play the songs and we tell the stories and add all those styles and tell where they come from, and that's very interesting and rich.
Well, and sometimes you take us from the south to the north of Brazil.
Well, that's
a geographic survey of the country.
Yeah, that concert was very fun. We went from the south to the north and exploring all composers, and you know, that was very, very fun.
You know, I went to the National Flute Association conference, I think it was Chicago, and they had a Brazilian session, a woman, Jean Lenoir. And she was talking about choro, and you know, it's funny what you remember. You know, you don't remember all of the things, but she said one thing I'll never forget. She said, "You guys are jazz musicians, you memorize the bebop tunes, memorize the choros." So you and I started doing that, with not as getting them off the page and memorizing them. And at first I thought it would be quite difficult, but just a few bars at a time, a few phrases at a time, and of course all the recording that we did here, we did by memory.
Yeah, that's choros are amazing and challenging too.
Yeah.
With all the bass lines, if you're trying to do every nuances that the seven-string guitar would do in the original, it's very, very cool.
And for the flute, I feel like I'm a classical flute player, you know, part of the time, most of the time, because of, you know, the complexity of, it's almost like a sonata.
That's true. And it's fun to see the rondó form.
Yes.
Present in that folk.
The classical form.
Exactly.
In folkloric music,
yeah.
It's beautiful. Brazilian music. Thanks for introducing me to it, Denis. It's great. I'm having a wonderful time. Hard work, though.
Yeah, that's true, yeah. But you know, like, I think that's the interesting thing about the combination, right? Like, Brazil-Canada connection, right? By playing with you, my way of playing also changed. You say that your way of playing also changed. Mm-hmm. So I can say the same thing. So John, when did you start getting interested in Brazilian music?
For me, right off the bat in the 1970s, you know, when I started playing as a professional musician, you know, the bossa nova was part of that. And then samba, a few of the samba tunes, you know, like one note samba was one of them. And the samba de Orfeu is another one, you know, that was quite popular. So, of course, Girl from Ipanema, that would have been the first one that I learned.
Oh, nice.
You know, Girl from Ipanema. And I used to just play them on flute. But Wave, to me, is one of the great, great songs of any era, of any style, you know. Jobim, of course, is a master.
One thing that we started doing this past year is writing together.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed that, and I'm looking forward to doing more. And one of the songs we wrote was Valen Samba, right? And it was very interesting because I arrived at your place, right? So we can could rehearsal, and then you showed me that melody and some chords and a draft, and then say, hey, what do you think about it? And then I really enjoyed it. And then we started adding some other chords, and we together started choosing the form, and suddenly we have this pretty fun piece to play, a very quick, fast samba. Yeah.
You know, it's a funny story behind that for me, from my point of view, because I woke up with that melody in my mind. And the funny thing was, I was thinking the key of C, you know, bum, 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 you know. So, but I knew that I had to go to the piano and to start to transcribe it, to write it down, because I'd forget, you know, you gotta write it down. But what I was singing was the key of B. Although I was seeing it in key of C. So then, okay, so I gotta write it in key of B. And then I thought, well, what if I do it in the key of C? And then what if I do both? And that's how the tune came to be in B, 1-4, and then to the E, and then to change keys completely to C and to F. So there's almost like four key changes.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Because we go from the 1 to 4, and then everything has to step up and back.
Yeah.
And the tempo is quite difficult to keep.
But the changes that you added were, you know, took a very basic chord structure that I had in mind and really spiced it up. I think it turned out very well.